For countless ages, the Kissimmee River meandered freely through the green canvas of Central Florida. The waters of this ancient river nourished a vast population of fish and wildlife, and provided sustenance to those who chose to live in harmony with her many moods. Those who know the rivers of the world compare her past to the great rivers of the southern hemisphere: the Amazon, the Senegal, the Niger. In truth, the Kissimmee was incomparable, answering only to her own rhythms, her own poetry. Then the Kissimmee's destiny changed. In a span of less than 10 years, the river was reduced to less than half its former size, its meandering shoreline replaced by the man-made banks of a canal, its waters controlled by floodgates and levees, its fish and wildlife decimated. Now there is a new vision for the Kissimmee. With the unprecedented cooperation of federal and state governments, biologists, engineers, and landowners, the Kissimmee may one day again take its rightful place among Florida's great rivers.
Hello, I'm Bill Shomo. I'm standing on land that was once covered by the Kissimmee River. It's pasture now, untouched by river water for almost a quarter century. Soon, very soon, the Kissimmee will flow over this land again. And hopefully, the complex ecosystem that once thrived here will be restored. This is the story of how a great Florida natural resource was tamed, and the steps that are being taken to reestablish it. It will be the largest, most sophisticated, most expensive project of its kind in history. And the world is watching.
It took a special breed of men and women to settle in Central Florida at the beginning of the 20th century. Most newcomers, streaming down from the north toward growing coastal towns and cities, regarded the Central Florida interior with disdain. Others had a different vision. A handful of hardy souls saw farms and ranches.
Well, we used the river right up to the river's edge because there was good pasture land on the west side of it. And we'd drive our cattle in there and keep them in there in the wintertime.
The river began near Orlando, in the beautiful waters of Central Florida's Upper Chain of Lakes region. This exaggerated view shows how more than a dozen interconnected shallow lakes flowed into Lake Kissimmee, which in turn discharged its waters into a river bearing the same name. The Kissimmee flowed south to Lake Okeechobee, becoming a vital element of the vast Kissimmee-Okeechobee Everglades landscape. Summer rains regularly caused the Kissimmee to overflow its narrow channels, flooding wide expanses of adjacent land. Due to this unique floodplain habitat, the native population of fish and wildlife in the Kissimmee River Basin was abundant and rich with diversity.
The first time I saw it, it was a wide river, a lot of water hyacinths, a lot of wildlife, the abundance of birds, all kind of fish. It was just old Florida. It was probably just the way it had been for thousands of years.
Pristine and free, the Kissimmee nourished them all.
When the water levels in the river rose, the river overflowed its bank and thereby inundated the entire 40,000 acres of floodplain wetlands. This was particularly important to the fish and wildlife resources of the basin because it provided them high quality habitat on the floodplain. Fish species, for example, were able to move on to the floodplain and utilize the vast wetland resources for feeding and for reproducing. Wading bird species were also afforded this great array of floodplain habitats. Now, when the water levels began to recede, or when water levels dropped, the resources that were produced on the floodplain, like the small fish and invertebrates, were brought back into the river channel and thereby provided food for the riverine food web.
Periodically, the Kissimmee exacted a price for its gifts. Farmers and ranchers with land near the floodplain often found their crops and livestock standing in shallow lakes. In 1948, a hurricane, followed by several years of violent storms, flooded more than 250,000 acres in and around the Kissimmee River Valley.
It was amazing. The water was from shore to shore. It was several miles wide, flowing. Automobiles could not even get over the bridge. In fact, the bridge was a wooden bridge, and part of it was washed away.
The flood stirred public sentiment, causing an outcry for flood control. In 1961, the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers began a mammoth flood control project in the Kissimmee Basin.
In the early 60s, when I went down there and saw it, this giant crane pumping dirt on each side, filling up the marshes, filling up the oxbows. The water was muddy, full of tugboats, full of diesel oil. And then I knew that from right there, it looked like they were building the Panama Canal or the Hoover Dam. And I knew right then that we'd made a mistake, and I knew that the Kissimmee River would never be like it used to be.
Back then, we went through an economic analysis to determine what method was best to be used to do our projects. And in this case, for flood control, Kissimmee was thought to be the best method was actually evacuation of the water from the floodplain as quickly as possible. And that was the basic design that was used in the construction of C-38 followed that, which quickly removed the water from the floodplain and then moved it downstream to, at the time, was thought to be areas that, that could handle it.
The river's serpentine channels were transformed into a deep, wide canal. More than 30,000 acres of floodplain wetlands were drained or covered with sand and ancient shell debris from the excavations. Six water control structures and locks were constructed along the length of the canal. It took nature an eternity to etch the ancient Kissimmee into the Florida landscape. It took 20th century engineering and machines, 10 years, and $28 million to obliterate it.
I'm standing on the bank of the C-38 Canal. This bank was formed by what engineers call spoil. As the canal was excavated, the material, the spoil, was simply tossed up here on the adjacent wetlands. And this is how the Kissimmee looks today, 300 feet wide, 30 feet deep.